Hey buddies, today I will be introducing to you another great method on how you can go about the FRP lock in Oppo phone and Realme. So with me here I have three files here. The first one is the SP flash tool. This one will be helping us, and the MTK. So this MTK address files will help you to download the specific firmware for a particular Realme or Oppo device, as I'll be showing you in the video how you can go about it, like in removing the FRP lock, either button or screen lock, everything at once. So I'll go ahead to show you everything, and I'll provide all the links in the description, so kindly go ahead and download. Then also, you guys, if you've not subscribed to our channel, kindly smash that bell icon by subscribing, then you won't miss out on any updates on this channel. So click next. Then I'll click finish to finalize with the installation process. So here we go, guys, this is the tool I've just installed. So I'll go ahead to double click on it. With the installation process, this is our tool. I'll go ahead to double click on it. So after opening the tool, as you can see here, you can go ahead to select the model of the phone which you want to work upon, depending on which model you want to work upon, which you want to remove the FRP lock, button, pin, everything. So you check that device by checking through this list. You can scroll in this list. For example, Oppo Realme 15, like that. For example, I'll choose a model for demonstration purpose. Then after selecting it, you'll go ahead to download the file. So as you can see, the download is pending at the moment because I've not commanded the download file. I'll click to download the file for demonstration purpose. So they're asking me where to save it. I'll just save it here in this folder. I'll click open, then I'll save it here. So we shall wait for it to download and finish it. As you can see now, it's already downloaded. So we shall come back here to this folder and open our folder. As you can see here, you can see what I've just installed now. It's just here. So you can go ahead to extract it here. So this is the extracted folder. So this is what embeds. There is the div file, the agent, and everything. So what we shall do here, we shall go ahead to check address. So you can see it is showing us the address which we have to use. Everything is indicated here in the video. As you can see, it is giving us, if you want to remove user data plus password, you have to use this. Then if you want to remove the MI cloud, you use this begin address, use this one. And if you want to remove FRP, you use this one. So now I'll show you what to do. So you come back here one step aside, then you open the SP flash tool. Shall go ahead to open the SP flash tool. We shall run the SP flash tool. Shall click on OK. So when you open the Flash tool, we shall go ahead to load the scatter file. So the scatter file, we shall choose it from what we've just downloaded. So this one is on our desktop. So it's on our desktop in this folder. So this is the scatter file. So after loading it, this is the authentication file. We shall just ignore it. Then as you can see, we shall remove this one and leave this preloader. Then we shall click on format. So after clicking on format, then we shall click on manual format flash. Then as you can see here, the begin address is this one, then the format length is this one. So we shall use this one to help us, depending on which problem we want to work upon. If you want to remove the user data plus passcode, then you have to use this one. If you want to remove the FRP law, then you have to use this one. So you can go ahead to copy this one and paste them here. For example, I'll show you for demonstration purpose. What you can do here is you'll go ahead to copy this. Shall go ahead to copy this begin address. Copy this one. Then paste it here. So likewise, the same to this one, the second one. So we shall remove this one, then go ahead and paste it here. So what you should do, you have to make sure your phone is turned off, then you press the volume down, then you plug in the USB cable, then you'll click on start, then it will continue and work upon this one. After this this bar loads, it will show you everything, then after it will be done. So that's the simple way of downloading the address files for Oppo and Mi devices. Watching, I'll drop all the links for the download in the description. Just go ahead and download so that you can try it yourself. Then just, if this method is helpful for you, you can just drop a comment in the comment section down below. Thank you for watching. Bye.